Hi everyone, and welcome to this really special Carrigaline Concert for Hope 2021 in aid of Cork ARC Cancer Support House. Isn't technology fantastic? I mean, there you are, watching from home, and like many of you, I'm shielding during treatment myself, so I'm doing my bits from home. And in the Carrigaline Court Hotel, we have a super lineup of performers ready to go. Linda Kenny, Brian Murphy, Lorna Hughes and Darragh Murphy have chosen a gorgeous programme with music from the musicals, the movies and just some really gorgeous feel-good nostalgia. And then on piano all evening, we're delighted to have the fantastic Denise Crowley as well as legend Brian Hyland on guitar. So I hope you're sitting comfortably and somewhere relaxed and you're ready to take a break from the outside world for a while and just enjoy yourself with us. Of course, everyone is here to help and support a very special charity, Cork ARC Cancer Support House. It's a service and organisation that has really and truly held the hands of so many people through a cancer journey, and they do that with love and hope. So over the course of the concert, we're going to remind you of the number to text. All you're going to have to do is text the word GIFT to 50300. We'll display it regularly on screen with the usual T's and C's. And if you can text while you're watching, thank you so much. And each text will cost you just €4.
Signor, stat qui, non sarei come tu mi vuoi, minandro. Ma già lo so, sempre tu sarai in me. You can't.
And I wish you joy and happiness. Il lontano da me l'amor amore, non mai l'amore sei tu, l'amore sei tu, mai l'amore sei tu.
Now, this concert has been brought together by our musical director and violinist this evening, also on keys, Brian Murphy. And besides being such an accomplished and talented musician, Brian has been the person behind bringing people like Catherine Jenkins, Il Divo and Jose Carreras to Cork for multiple sellout concerts, not just in places like City Hall, but stadiums like Musgrave Park. And he's been behind these concerts in lockdown too since the pandemic began last year. So we're really grateful to him for pulling the team together and making it all happen. Tonight, he's going to play one of the most beautiful melodies for violin, the theme from Schindler's List. It's from a score by John Williams, who was daunted at the time at having to write something for the movie when Steven Spielberg showed it to him. And instead, he went on to write a masterpiece which stops you in your tracks and still evokes so much deep emotion, no matter how many times we hear it.
Thank you.
I'm so pleased to introduce our next singer, Lorna Hughes. Lorna is a member of the Carrigaline Musical Society, which was formed only about 5 years ago. But in that short time, they've taken on huge productions. They've made such an impact and they've sold out every single show. Singing as part of a cast or a team is, of course, wonderful, and Lorna loves it. But at Christmas, she was persuaded to sing on her own and everyone just adored her. So we had to have her back. By day, she works in Abode, which provides services to those living with physical and sensory disabilities. But by night, it would seem she has a great future to be built as a concert singer too. So she's going to begin this evening with one of Sarah McLachlan's best loved songs, Angel.
The break that would make it okay. There's always some reason to feel not good enough, and it's hard at the end of the day. I need some distraction. Oh, beautiful release. Vultures and thieves at your back. Storm keeps on twisting. Keep on building the lies that you made up for all that you lack. It don't make no difference. Escaping one last time, it seems. Hotel room and the end
Blood Brothers is one of the most popular musicals loved by Irish audiences, and every single time there's a revival or a tour, the opera house sells out. The story of Mrs. Johnson and her twin baby boy is sure to just break your heart. Because she was too poor to raise both, she gives up one baby to a wealthy family. And as children, the boys meet and, finding out that they share a birthday, decide to become blood brothers. But as young men, they both fall for the same woman with tragic consequences because in a confrontation which ends in an accidental shooting, both brothers die. And the song their mother sings at the end of the show, when the secret she's been keeping is finally revealed, is one of the biggest hits of musical theatre. So to sing it, here's Linda Kenny with Tell Me It's Not True.
Willie Russell's Blood Brothers was the very first musical that I ever saw in the Cork Opera House, and it had a profound effect on me and opened up the whole world of musical theatre. This next song is probably the most iconic song from that show. It's the emotional Tell Me It's Not True.
Of the
Here's another sumptuous violin melody. This time it's from Bizet's opera Carmen. Carmen wants José to join the smugglers, but he wants to lead an honest life. And Carmen is disappointed by what she sees as cowardice, and she mocks him. But then José swears his love for her, and he reminds her of the flower she threw down to him. La fleur que tu m'avais jetée.
Thank you.
don't you miss being in a big crowd for a gig? I mean, I hope you're really enjoying this at home, but like, wouldn't it just be great to be packed in shoulder to shoulder? And you know, one of the best atmosphere gigs I was ever at was in my very early 20s, and it was a Neil Diamond gig in the round in Croke Park. And those were the days when everyone had lighters, of course. And I remember the gas that was burned with everyone roaring for Sweet Caroline at the tops of our voices. But there were other songs that he brought the entire stadium to silence with, even those of us who were up for the laugh. And this is one of them. Believe it or not, it began as a 45 second theme tune for a sitcom. Only the producers changed their tack and picked a different song, but it was their loss. The sitcom died and the song lived on. Here's Lorna Hughes with You Don't Bring Me Flowers.
Flowers, you don't sing me love songs, you hardly talk to me anymore when you come through the door at the end of the day. I remember when you couldn't wait to love me.
Once again this evening, we're reminding you that the partner charity for this concert is Cork Arc Cancer Support House. And from counselling to a multitude of physical therapies, they really provide the most incredible support to patients and their families when somebody has cancer. Isn't that fantastic? I mean, you never think you're going to need that kind of help yourself. And yet there isn't any of us who doesn't know somebody who's been touched by cancer in some way. So you never think it could be you. But if it ever is, from that first phone call you make when you're in a whirlwind of emotions and fear, when you actually can't see hope, they're there. And they have worked so hard in recent years to create a very special service in Cork City and also in Bantry, where you're literally enveloped in love and care when you go in the door. If you need somewhere to cry, somewhere to laugh, somewhere to connect with other people who know exactly what you're going through, or whether you need therapies which help you through the journey, they really have thought of it all. And they don't forget the family members either, you know, husbands, wives, sons and daughters, parents who are all beside themselves with worry, of course. There are services for them too. Honestly, it's just outstanding. And all we're asking is that you send a text while you're watching the concert, either live or on repeat, and send the word gift to 50300. The terms and conditions are all the usual ones on screen now, and the text will cost just €4. And whether you text once or a few times is totally up to you. But Cork Arc would like to sincerely thank you all for being so generous. And we would like to sincerely thank them all for all they've done for cancer sufferers in Cork. So now for our next piece, Lorna is going to be accompanied on acoustic guitar by Darragh Murphy. Darragh is studying for his leaving certificate this summer, and I don't think this is a year he'll ever forget, but I hope that tonight creates one of the lovely memories of the year. Now, despite his musical talent, he has his sights set on other areas in college, but I think music will always be a part of him, and we're so glad he's joined the cast this evening. We have some gorgeous love songs on the show, but I think this is one of the most contemporary of them. It's an Ed Sheeran number and yet another of his singles which topped charts worldwide. It was written as a love song to his wife before they were married. They met as children and then reconnected in New York as adults, and he always thought she was indeed perfect.
The car.
If there's anything we've come to realise in this last year, it's that material things don't matter a jot. The really important things are your people. The people that you have in your heart. The people that live in your family, in your communities, who may be living far away or in their heavenly home. These are the people that we want to keep in our hearts, full of love, and keep them forever young. So this song may not have been written like this, but we see this song as a prayer and a tribute to all those wonderful people that are important to us. May God bless and keep you always. May your wishes all come true. May you always do for others, and let others do for you. May you build a ladder to the stars, and climb on every rung. May you stay. Forever young. May you stay. crazy. May your feet always be swift. May you have a strong foundation when the winds of changes shift. May your heart always be joyful. May your songs always be strong. May you stay.
Unrequited love might sometimes feel hopeless, but you know, it can inspire the most beautiful music and poetry. Here's the gorgeous theme from the movie Ladies in Lavender, which is set in Cornwall, where two sisters, Janet and Ursula, discover a handsome stranger who's been washed up on the beach near their house. He turns out to be a gifted violinist whom they nurse back to health, and Janet falls for him. Well, you'll have to watch the movie. It stars Dames Judi Dench and Maggie Smith. And here's Brian Murphy with the gorgeous theme.
Thank you.
Now, I would like to dedicate this next piece to all those who work in Cork Arc. They really are a tremendous group of people, from the volunteers who man the phones, and they really are the most grover people who are the first point of contact when you pluck up the courage to ring. They're just fantastic. To all the therapists and professionals who work there, a big hello from all of us, and especially this year when cancer services were put under so much pressure as a result of the pandemic. I mean, trying to offer as much as they have done online is extraordinary. So we really want you to text the word gift to 50300, and that will donate to Cork Arc Cancer Support House while you're watching the concert. And that will be the best thanks that we can give them, to support them, to support others, and give others hope. So besides offering hope, I'm just really enjoying all the songs with a theme of love and romance this evening, from anyone who can't help falling in love, to finding someone who's perfect, to not getting flowers, to having flowers thrown to a lover. Well, all the emotions are there, aren't they? So here's one which goes back a little further than the rest. It would have been one people associated long ago with Ciarán MacMahon's programme Bright and Early on Sunday mornings, mainly because of its sublime Irish air on the violin. But back in the 1800s, Samuel Ferguson set words to it, and it's simply a poetic declaration of romance and how the writer intends to tell his beloved how he really feels. It's the lark in the clear air. Dear thoughts are in my mind, and my soul soars enchanted as I hear the sweet lark sing in the clear air of the day. For a tender, beaming smile to my hope has been granted. And tomorrow she shall hear all my fond heart has to say. I shall tell her of my love, of my soul's adoration, and I think she will hear, and will not say me nay. This which gives my soul all its joyous elation. As I hear the sweet lark sing in the clear air of the day.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's that time of the evening where we've got to say goodbye. This time last year, when we did our very first Concert for Hope, little did we think that we would be here a year later. But it's so wonderful to not only get the chance to sing, but to hopefully raise some much-needed funds for this amazing charity, Arc House. So we're going to do you a song now that we want you to all join in with. It's most associated with a very, very well-known singer, Finbar Fiori, but I know you know the words, so I won't say any more.
when first I saw the love light in your eyes, I thought the world held naught but joy for me. And even though we drifted far apart, I never dreamed but what I dream of thee.
Let's hear you.
I love you as I never loved before. When first I saw you on the village green, come to me ere my dreams of love are more. I love you as I loved you when you were sweet.
Say goodnight with something a little bit cheekier, or maybe a little bit more frivolous. And we want to hear you sing, lift those rafters with a song called Those Were the Days. Once upon a time, there was a tavern where we used to raise a glass or two. Remember how we away the hours and think of all the good things we would do. Those were the days, my friend. We thought they'd never end. We'd sing and dance forever and a day. We'd live the life we choose. We'd fight and sure to have our way. La 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 la. Then the busy years went rushing by us. We lost our starry notions on the way. If by chance I'd see you in the tavern, we'd smile at one another and we'd say, those were the days, my friend. We thought they'd never end. last night I stood before a tavern. Nothing seemed the way it used to be. In the glass I saw a strange reflection. Was that lonely woman really me? Those were the days, my friend. We thought they'd never end. We'd sing and dance forever and a day. We'd live the life we choose. We'd fight and never lose. Those were the days. Oh yes. Saw your face and heard you call my name. Oh, my friend, we're older but no wiser. For in our hearts the dreams are still the same. Those words. They'd never end. We'd sing and dance forever and a day. We'd live the life we choose. We'd fight and never lose. Those were the days. Oh yes, those were the days.
And so our concert draws to a close, and I hope you've enjoyed it. Well, I know you have. So a huge thank you to Brian and Darragh Murphy, to Linda Kenny, Lorna Hughes, Brian Hyland and Denise Crowley, and of course our tech team, the Carrigaline Court Hotel for hosting this special event, Cork Arc Cancer Support House for the work they do for all of us, and you, not just for watching, but for donating and being so generous. Now, this concert link will stay on YouTube, so you can enjoy the concert over and over, or you could share it with friends and spread the word about donating to Cork Arc. And if you have any queries about the services Cork Arc has to offer, then simply visit their website at corkcancersupport.ie. So all that remains is just to wish you all a beautiful spring and a beautiful summer ahead. Garv Mila Mahagoyf Galer.